हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम दर्शनी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट विल्सन्स थ्योरम, विच गिव्स अस वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ प्राइम नंबर्स एंड कैन बी यूज्ड एज अ प्राइमलिटी टेस्ट टू चेक वेदर अ गिवन पॉजिटिव इंटीजर इज अ प्राइम नंबर और नॉट. लेट्स गेट विल्सन्स थ्योरम. लेट P be a prime number, then P minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo P. Okay. To prove this, first let us check when P is equal to 2. Proof. For P equal to 2, 2 minus 1 factorial, which is 1, is congruent to minus 1 modulo 2. So 1 minus of minus 1 is 2, which is divisible by 2. For P equal to 3, we have 3 minus 1 factorial, which is 2, is again congruent to minus 1 modulo 3. Since 2 minus of minus 1 is 3, which is divisible by 3. So this result holds good for P equal to 2 and P equal to 3. So let P greater than 3. Okay. Now let me consider an integer. Let A be an integer in the set 1, 2, 3 and so on. P minus 1. Every integer in this set is less than P and hence relatively prime to P, since P is a prime number. This implies that GCD of A and P is 1. So the linear congruence, AX congruent to 1 modulo P has a unique solution, since the GCD of AP is 1, has a unique solution. Let A dash be a solution. Let A into A dash be congruent to 1 modulo P. Now let us check in what cases A and A dash will be equal. Suppose if A equal to A dash, then by this we have A into A, which is A square, is congruent to 1 modulo P. This implies A square is congruent to 1 modulo P. When I use the definition of congruence, I get here P divides A square minus 1, or P divides A minus 1 into A plus 1. Since P is a prime number, we should have P divides A minus 1 or P divides A plus 1. Observe here, A is an integer less than P and P is a prime number. So this should be equal to either 0 or P itself. Here we have two integers, so this should be equal to 0 and this should be equal to P. A minus 1 should be equal to 0, or A plus 1 should be equal to P, or A equal to 1, or A equal to P minus 1. So we have shown that A will be equal to A dash only if A equal to 1 or A equal to P minus 1. 1 is congruent to 1 modulo P, and P minus 1 is congruent to minus 1 modulo P. Let us take this as 1. Okay. First we started with the set 1, 2, 3 up to P minus 1. So we had P minus 1 number of elements. Eliminating these two elements, we get this set 2, 3, 4 and so on P minus 2, which contains P minus 1 minus 2, which is P minus 3 number of elements. So in this set, 2, 3, 4 up to P minus 2, we have p minus 3 number of distinct elements. So we can find p minus 3 by 2 number of distinct pairs such that a into a dash congruent to 1 modulo p. So we can find p minus 3 by 2 number of distinct pairs of a and a dash such that a into a dash is congruent to 1 modulo p. So observe that since p is an odd number, p minus 3 by 2 is a positive integer. Now multiplying all those congruences, multiplying all such congruences, we get the product of elements of this set. We get 2 into 3 into 4 up to p minus 2 is congruent to 1 modulo p. Okay, let us take this as 2. Now when we multiply 1 and 2, we get by 1 and 2, we get 2 into 3 into 4 into p minus 2 into p minus 1 into 1 is p minus 1 factorial, which is congruent to 1 into 1 into minus 1, which is minus 1 modulo p. Okay. So this completes the proof of Wilson's theorem. So I told you in the beginning that Wilson's theorem can be used as a primality test. So here we have a note. Converse of the Wilson's theorem is true. That is, if for a positive integer n, if n minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo n, then n is a prime number. Okay. We know that if p is a prime number, p minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 mod p. Conversely, if n minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 mod n, then n should be a prime number. Proof. So given that n minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo n, so by the definition of congruence, I have n divides n minus 1 factorial plus 1. To prove that n is a prime number, I am going to use contradiction method. Suppose if n is composite, then n has a non-trivial factorization. N can be written as a into b, where a and b are strictly less than n and strictly greater than 1. So here n is equal to a into b. So n is a product of, integral product of a. So a divides n. We have that n divides n minus 1 factorial plus 1. So a divides n minus 1 factorial plus 1. But since a is less than n, a should divide n minus 1 factorial. When I combine these two, let me take this as 1 and this as 2. When I combine these two, I get by 1 and 2, a divides 1, which is a contradiction because a is greater than 1, which is a contradiction. We arrived at a contradiction because of our wrong assumption that n is a composite number, therefore n should be a prime number. Therefore n is a prime number. Now let us consider some problems. First problem, find the remainder when 15 factorial is divided by 17. Solution. We know that 17 is a prime number. So by Wilson's theorem, we have 17 minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 mod 17. This can be written as 16 factorial congruent to minus 1 mod 17. I expand this factorial to get 15 factorial. This is same as 16 into 15 factorial congruent to, since we are considering mod 17, we can add or subtract 17 as many times as we need. When I add 17 to minus 1, I get here 16 mod 17. Okay. Now observe that we have 16 in the LHS and RHS, and we also know that the GCD of 16 and 17 is 1. Since GCD of 16 and 17 is 1, we can cancel 16 on both the sides. We have 15 factorial is congruent to 1 mod 17. So we have shown that when 15 factorial is divided by 17, the remainder is 1. Therefore, 1 is the required remainder. Okay. Consider the next problem. Show that 10 factorial is congruent to 32 mod 143. Solution. Observe that 143 is not a prime number. When I factorize 143, I get 11 into 13. So 143 is a product of two distinct prime numbers. Since 11 is a prime number, by Wilson's theorem, I have 11 minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 11, or 10 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 11. As we are considering mod 11, we can add or subtract 11 as many times as we need. Here to get 32, when I add minus 1 to 11, I get 10. 10 plus 11 is 21. 21 plus 11 is 32. So minus 1 is congruent to 32 mod 11. This implies 10 factorial is congruent to 32 mod 11. So let me take this as 1. Now again, since 13 is a prime number, again, since 13 is a prime number, by Wilson's theorem, I have 13 minus 1 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 13, or 12 factorial is congruent to minus 1 modulo 13. Okay. Now I expand this to get 10 factorial. So this can be written as 12 into 11 into 10 factorial is congruent to minus 1 mod 13. Now I know that 12 is congruent to minus 1 modulo 13, and 11 is congruent to minus 2 modulo 13. So this can be written as minus 1 into minus 2 into 10 factorial congruent to, when I add 13 to minus 1, because 13 is congruent to 0 modulo 13, so we can add or subtract 13 as many times as we need. So when I add 13 to minus 1, I get 12. 12 mod 13. So we have 2 into 10 factorial is congruent to 2 × 6 modulo 30. Observe that we have 2 in the LHS and 2 in the RHS. We also know that the GCD of 2 and 13 is 1. So we can cancel 2 on both sides. I get 10 factorial congruent to 6 modulo 30. As I said earlier, since we are considering mod 13, we can add or subtract 13 as many times as we need. To get 32, I'm going to add 13 to 6. 13 plus 6 is 19. 19 plus 13 is 32. So this is same as 10 factorial congruent to 32 mod 30. So let me take this as 2. So in the first congruence, we have 10 factorial congruent to 32 mod 11. In the second congruence, we have 10 factorial congruent to 32 mod 13. From 1, I have 11 divides 10 factorial minus 32. From 2, we have 13 divides 10 factorial minus 32. And we also know that GCD of 11 and 13 is 1. So the product of 11 and 13, which is 143, should also divide 10 factorial minus 32. 143 divides 10 factorial minus 32. When I write this in the congruence form, I get 10 factorial is congruent to 32 mod 143. Okay, this is the solution.